temptation overtaken and a fault, ye that are spiritual, you're supposed to go to that brother, the Bible says, in the spirit of meekness.
Yes.
You don't go arrogant and full of yourself. I knew you wasn't about that.
Yeah.
Let me get you told about yourself. You go to him at first in the spirit of meekness. The Bible says trying to restore that brother. It says considering yourself, lest you fall.
Yeah.
In the hood, we say it like this. Better be careful, their dog got their day.
Yeah. Amen.
It'll be your turn after a while.
Amen.
You're going to have the issue next time. So don't be so quick to throw folk away. Now, it's some folk you have to throw away.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
they don't mean no good.
Yeah.
You ever had somebody where you exhausted all your niceness?
Yeah.
I did everything I could do to be kind to you,
yeah.
and they still want to have a fool.
Yeah.
You a fool if you keep putting up with that fool.
Yeah.
Let me move on.
Amen.
Amen. I see why y'all in today. Ain't nobody saying amen. But y'all in the teaching spirit. So let me slow down and teach a little bit. And that's what y'all want to hear. Let me help you right here. If y'all can't say amen, you just told me you've been that fool. Amen. But Jonathan, you can tell in the church, see, in the world, a hit dog will holler. In the church, hit dogs get very quiet.
Yeah.
And they start looking at the preacher funny. Yeah. Are y'all hear what I'm saying? And if you know back to church, you ever been through the old back to church, they get sickness when they don't like what the preacher's saying. Watch it, Reverend.
Yeah.
Are y'all hear what I'm saying? Then when the preacher say something they don't like, fix it, preacher. I had one guy so mad at me when I was Patrick Stone Chapel. She was hollering for the choir saying, get out of these folk being the preacher. I said, you just told me I'm talking about you. But Jonathan, Saul's son, delighted much in David. And Jonathan told David, can we talk in the 2015 voice cat? Hey man, you my dog. My daddy want to kill you. That's all that just happened in a nutshell. See, he went to his son and said, hey, I want to kill your boy. My boy, he had a decision to make. He said, do I protect my friend or do I do what my daddy said? You got to always side with who right. Sometimes controversy is not avoidable. Sometimes you deal with issues that need to be fixed. Even the Bible says, when possible, be at peace with all brethren. Why do you think the word of God says when possible? Because sometimes peace just ain't a possibility.
Amen.
Come on, preach up.
Y'all quiet. Amen. Sometimes you done push me to a level where I need to handle my business.
Amen.
And for you good Jesus freak that say that wasn't the Lord, you ain't read all Jesus' business. The Bible said when Jesus walked in the temple and found them had turned the house of God into pretty much a casino where wasn't nothing going on but money changes in the store. The Bible say Jesus ain't walking here like y'all all be talking about Jesus, what a wonderful child, so holy me and mine. The Bible said Jesus walked in the sanctuary, started kicking over chairs, kicking over tables, let the animal go, and he went off.
Yeah.
Yes,
he did.
Yeah.
Y'all quiet.
Yes, he did. Yeah. Y'all that don't know the Bible, y'all be talking about, that ain't the Jesus I know, but you don't know Jesus.
Yeah.
It was always time to be cool. And I tell folks all the time, Jesus never rebuked Peter for cutting that ear off. I hear preachers all the time about when Peter cut the ear off, Jesus rebuked him. No, he didn't.
Nope.
Jesus turned around and told him, do know, if you live like this, you're going to die. Jesus didn't say, you're wrong to defend yourself. He said, just don't live like this. Because
Amen.
If you live like this, it's going to cost you eventually.
Amen.
That's how you're going to leave him.
Amen.
How many glad you changed your ways?
Amen.
Y'all quiet. I can flow whatever y'all protect me. Come on, amen. That's when y'all been shouting and running around. Let me teach you. God bless you. Amen. It says, but listen. Say, Saul, my father, seeking to kill me. Now, therefore, watch this present. I pray thee, take heed to thyself until morning. Listen, Keisha. Listen, Val. God talking to me about some folk. Abide in a secret place and hide thyself. And I will go out and stand beside my father in the field where thou art. And I will commune with my father of thee. And what I see, that will I tell thee. Cat, it's some homeboy stuff going on now. You know what the Lord told me to tell some of y'all this morning? If you're going to survive, you got to learn how to listen. listen to somebody that know more about the situation than you do.
Amen.
That's some of our problem with survival. We hard-headed.
Yeah.
Amen.
Some of our problem with survival, we know it all.
Mm-hmm.
Some of our problem with survival, we done kind of Negro, can't nobody tell you nothing.
Amen.
And you ain't willing to listen until your behind gets sore. Because old folks say a hard head. I'm going to say make a soul in the day. Y'all hear what I'm saying? And we be willing to listen after the devil finished whooping your butt.
Yeah.
Now, David had a choice to make here. Do I listen before my butt get kicked? Or if I don't, I might not be around. Because this Joe was trying to kill me.
Yeah.
How many understand that the devil has you in a situation not to irritate you? Ultimately, the devil wants you to lose your mind.
Yes.
Amen.
How many know the ultimate devil wants you to give in to depression?
Yes.
How many ultimately know the devil wants you to look at your situation and just give up? And if he could, how many understand the devil would love to kill you?
Amen.
And if he doesn't kill you physically, at least he wants to take your joy.
Amen.
Am I talking to anybody?
Amen.
The first step to getting out of your situation is having ears open to somebody that knows what's going on.
Amen.
It might not be in the natural, but you need to listen to somebody that can hear in the spirit of man. You need to not talk to that next Negro that ain't got the same, that got the same situation you got.
All right.
Number one problem we talk to folks all the time, ain't doing no bad nuts.
Yeah, all right. All right.
I'm gonna hang out right there. A poor man, another poor man can't tell you how to get rich. Amen. Another lonely woman can't tell you how to get a ring. Amen. Y'all start checking them folks that been divorced 4 or 5 times. Then you got your man, they say, and I was you. That's the one person you don't listen to. You been me 4 times. Oh, y'all quiet in here. Don't you listen to no brother about how to keep your woman? And you ain't never seen him with them. And you're wondering, is he sweeter than the honey on the honeycomb?
All right.
Amen. I'm wrong. So, Jonathan told him, go hide yourself.
Yeah.
All the time, it ain't time to go be big time.
Amen.
Sometimes you got to back up and take a sabbatical.
Amen.
Sometimes you got to hear from God so you can tell what's going on. We in this generation now, we running that full force. I'm gonna have it. Oh, you need to get a strategy. Because the Bible says that the wiles of Satan are against you. Put on the full armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles. That means strategies of Satan. By the time Satan launches something against you, he done studied you.
Yeah.
Yeah, he has.
He done sat back and checked out your proclivities.
Come on,
he done checked out prayer and said, he like that kind of woman. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? He like that kind of woman. And the minute prayer said, I'm gonna live right in the air of my life. How many know that's gonna switch right by our eyeballs?
Amen.
Oh, it's quiet right now.
Amen.
Amen. How many of y'all had a satanic attack when you got your man to do right?
Amen.
Oh, it's quiet. Thank you, Mama. They don't want to talk to me today, but just pray for me. We're gonna get through this together, okay? And it says, watch this. He said, and Jonathan spake good of David unto Saul, his father, somebody on the inside working for him, and said to him, look, let not the king sin against his servant, against David, because he have not sinned against thee, and because his works have been to thee were very good. For he did put his life in thy hand, and slew the Philistines, and the Lord wrought a great salvation for all Israel. Thou saw thee, and did rejoice. Wherefore then wilt thou sin against innocent blood, to slay David without a cause? He said, you ain't got no reason to sit around here and treat David like that. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? You need to stop doing that. Look what Saul did. Are you ready? And Saul hearkened unto the voice of Jonathan, and Saul swear, as the Lord liveth, he shall not be slain. Everybody breathe. Let it go. How many know in the midst of your worst situation, sometimes God will give you a breather?
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Never Abel was probably trying to kill you, but how many had a hard?
Amen.
And you had a hard day,
amen,
after day, after day.
Yep.
Every way you look in life, you had trouble.
Amen.
But after a while, in the midst of your issues, the issue wasn't over, but God came and gave you a little breath.
Yep.
Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? more strength.
Yes.
To finish going through the rest of what you got to go through.
Yes.
See, some of y'all know what I'm talking about, because some of you sitting in here, you thought your breather minute was over.
Yeah.
How many had your breather before and you thought the problem had got finished?
Yes.
And you found out all that was a breather. I'm glad God know when I get weak, it can't take no more.
Hallelujah.
And I come give you a breather and say, but why are you breathing? I'm going to strengthen you to go back and fight the rest of the fight. Your break.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all, come on, y'all better talk to me.
Yeah.
I've seen God slide in about 2 good days in the middle of 10 bad days.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you said, at least because God knew, I need 3 people to shout that understand this. If I hadn't had that 1.5 good days, I would have reached my breaking point. Hallelujah. I need a little something to smile about. It ain't all fixed. I know it ain't all. Yesterday I said I had a little bit of a good time. Yesterday was as close to a smile as I could possibly have. I had time to breathe. I know the big issue still exists.
Can I help you, brother? What that does is give me hope.
Let me help you. If he was able to give me a 24, I need to talk to the military folks. If he was able to give me a 24-hour ceasefire, come on. That means God does know how to stop this war. For 24 hours, I can look for him to stop it for good at all. This ain't nothing but
2 or 3 days to breathe.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right. Now, I'm going to say this for those of y'all that's still sleeping on me. If you ain't never praised God for a little breathing room, you ain't never had a real problem. See, I don't know how you feel, but I've been so broke before, finding $2 or $3 in my pocket was a breather. But how many know it was a temporary fix for a long-term situation?
All right.
Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? Oh, are you sitting here, I just want to bust you out, you can't clap your hand? Y'all done went out of town for the weekend to get stuff straight. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? Had you some good business in the hotel for the weekend, but the minute the car hit back to Montgomery, going back to the same
you're preaching now.
Lifestyle.
Come on.
Y'all know what I'm talking about. I see folks smiling at me all over the church because they can't say amen. Because you're scared who's sitting next to you going to hit you in the ribs.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Don't you sit here and act like we ain't just left time just to get a change of scenery. See if we can bring it out. See if we can forget about reality. Oh, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Lou, that's why some men drink. Because if I get drunk, I ain't got to think about it.
All right.
I almost forgot who y'all preacher is. Are y'all hear what I'm saying? I talk about the real deal. That's why I'm high.
That's right.
But when I'm high, I ain't got to think about how you keep burning this chicken. Oh, y'all done helping me. Because y'all won't get with me, so I'm just going to go another deeper. That's why some of these ladies wind themselves up in the arms of somebody you know you wouldn't have been with. Y'all going to turn my back. You just trying to be like you do in the church song. Give yourself away. You just trying to forget about what's going on in your life. And what's going on in your everyday life is killing you. You will look for some relief in places you never would have if your man had been right. I thank God that in the midst of some of my hell, he gave me some little breaks. Some little time to breathe. Some happy days. Are y'all hear what I'm saying? Because you got big problems when the hell days outweigh the happy days.
Amen.
Now watch it, brother Mark. Somebody say,
day over.
Happy day over.
Talk louder and say, happy day over.
Happy day over.
Watch this. It says, and because Jonathan, you ain't gonna read and kill David. David the Lord you. He said, and Saul hearkened to the voice of Jonathan, and Saul swept. If the Lord liveth, he shall not be slain. And Jonathan called David, and Jonathan showed him all those things. And Jonathan brought David to Saul, and he was in his presence as in time passed. Now, I got to slow down here, and I got to talk about that because I want to. That's that hole right there. Can I go old school for a minute, Sister Mark? You know what that is right there? There's a song y'all you listen to now. Reunited, and it feels so good. See, you got to watch that.
Yes, yeah.
Y'all gonna hear what I'm saying?
Yes, you do. Yes, you do.
You was treating me like this here yesterday.
Yeah, right.
You seem like everything is good the next day.
Yeah.
Walt Jones treat you like
yes,
this. I watch for even they say we straight. Where did all that venom you had for me go?
Where did all that
ill see, Brother Manning can go have one conversation with you for me. But if you really don't like me, you just don't like me.
Amen.
Oh, y'all. See, one conversation don't fix what's wrong.
Amen.
When God has to do a work, I'm trying to help some of the young ladies now. God has to do a work on the inside of a joker's heart for them to change how they really feel towards you.
Yeah.
I like to put the mic down and walk out to the bottom. I feel like I'm a preacher, even though y'all ain't in front of today. Don't be fooled because of one good time.
Amen.
Bro, man, who am I preaching to? They're on top of the day, but they get good. Don't let one night out make you feel like everything all right. Just because he came by your house and got like Johnny Gill and rubbed you the right way, don't think everything is fine.
Amen.
They're not liking this. Are y'all hear what I'm saying? Just because she smashed that top. And showed a little leg, that don't mean.
Come on now,
y'all hear what I'm saying? What they got to do with the Bible? The Bible said Jonathan brought David back to the palace as time passed.
Uh-huh.
First thing the devil do to draw us back in, we have a good time, and then you get to yourself and say, it was just like old time.
Yeah.
I'm looking to see who I'm preaching to now. It's just like old times. You start feeling giddy. You start getting happy. You let stuff happen that you shouldn't let happen.
Amen.
Lord, you didn't tell me that I'm going to respond today on this one. I'm just talking to Jesus. Amen. Don't get tricked. I can't say the rest of the other things. Don't get tricked.
Come on.
Don't get tricked. Don't get tricked. And he was in his presence as in times past. That was war again. David went out, fought with the Philistines. David fighting for him now. Ladies, you right back to doing what you used to do for him. Brothers, you right back to spending that money like you used to spend for him. Are y'all hear what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
He still ain't no good and she's still a hoe.
All right.
Are y'all hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
But you right back to your usual business because they tricked you with that one shining moment.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's quiet in here. And slew them with a great slaughter, fighting for them. And they fled from David. David won the war for Saul. And the evil spirit from the Lord was upon Saul. And he sat in the house with his javelin in his hand, and David played with his hand. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. While David thinking everything all right, the evil spirit came right back on him. I need y'all to talk to me. Y'all done been there before, really. I don't have to spend a whole lot of time with that, right? I think everything fine, but then I get shocked there today. Who am I teaching to this morning? And when they list their complaint, you totally shocked. I thought everything was gonna be all right this time. I'm gonna help somebody. Are y'all ready for this? Everybody look at me. Y'all ready for this?
You know what the problem was? You know that this evil spirit didn't come from Satan.
Right.
You know the Bible said the evil spirit came from who? The Lord. You know what was going on right here? You know what was going on right here? God didn't want David and Saul hooked up no way.
Amen. Oh, y'all got quiet in here.
So God said, you know what? I got to send something down there that'll break up what I ain't had nothing to do with in the first place.
Yeah.
It's quiet in here. When God ain't in it, you ain't going to be able to make it right.
Amen.
So tomorrow, keep the door closed when you ready to try to walk out in a minute. When the Lord from hell.
Right.
It didn't say the evil spirit got released from Satan himself. It don't even sound right. Because it said the evil spirit came from the Lord. Now we know God ain't got nothing evil about him.
Right.
But what God went and did when got a demon and threw that demon toward that situation and said, break that up.
Right.
Because if I don't get David away from Saul, Saul will contaminate him, and I ain't gonna be able to take David where I want to take him.
Amen.
It ain't about your little feelings that's getting hurt, y'all. It's about God trying to take you to your destiny.
Amen.
And some of them folk you got surrounding you ain't nothing but destiny and dream killers. Somebody help me preach because they ain't liking what I'm saying today. You can pray all you want to about some of this stuff. It ain't gonna never get fixed because if God didn't start it, he ain't gonna finish it. You can't put God in the middle when you went and did what you wanted to do and expect God to start blessing something that was cursed from the beginning. God said, I'm gonna break it up because I know what I want to do with David.
Yeah.
I had a group of friends one time, I don't care what I did to help them. And I did everything for them boys all the way to paying the IRS so they wouldn't go to jail. In the end, when God said, I'm going to separate you and elevate you, I cried, I was upset, God tore all of it up. Because if God didn't ordain it, it ain't going to work.
Amen.
Now, am I teaching all right? Can I keep on? Now, David in there playing the harp, playing the music, I say playing with his hand, playing the whatever you call it. He didn't want the war for Saul. Look like Saul would be happy.
Yeah.
Bible says Saul sitting in the palace press with a javelin in his hand, contemplating, you know what? I listened to my son, Cat. But I still can't stand this nigga.
Yeah.
I heard what my boy said, but I don't care. And it's dangerous to play with somebody that got the power to kill you. Whether you're talking about physically, emotionally, or spiritually, it's dangerous to play around with some. See, when your heart open to folk, they can hurt you bad. You can't hurt me if you're not on the inside. The most dangerous people to your cause is the folk that your heart is open to. That's why the Bible says guard your heart with all due diligence, because out of your heart flows the issues of life. You got to start viewing your heart as being so precious that I can't let everybody in.
Amen.
Y'all better talk to me.
Amen.
And some folk I let in, amen, I got to find the courage to kick out. And once I kick them out, I got to close it up because I can't be afford to be hurt by somebody that they show they don't really love me.
Amen.
Am I talking to somebody today?
Amen.
Now, he went out there, fought on the battlefield again. Won the war. You ain't find that Saul went out and fought. David fighting for him. Come back in the palace where he ought to be able to get some love. And then Jehovah got a spear in his hand. I still want to kill him. Sometimes, no matter what you say, no matter what you do, it's not going to change a person toward you.
Amen.
Can Oh, can I say it again?
Amen.
Let me help you. You can't fix folk no way.
Amen.
Cause last time I checked, your name ain't Jesus.
Amen.
You are not the Christ.
Amen.
If God don't do it, it ain't gonna be done.
Right.
Who am I talking to?
Amen.
And Saul sought to smite David, even to the wall with the javelin, but he slipped away out of Saul's presence, and he smote the javelin to the wall, and David fled and escaped. Everybody look at me. Now, watch this. Like old folks say, that's a crying shame, man.
Yeah.
He looked at him long enough, and if you cuss, that's another kind of shame. He sat there and had that javelin in hand to where he just got full of anger and rage and threw it at the person that was blessing him.
Yeah.
You ever been hurt by somebody who was blessing?
Yeah.
I'm going to come over here. Anybody you was blessing ever done damage to your heart?
Amen.
Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? And see, I'm glad David was able to slip away, because sometimes them folk you blessing, they can hurt you because your God done.
Amen.
Are y'all hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
I'm glad Saul wasn't a good throw.
Yeah.
Because when he threw the javelin, he hit the wall.
Yeah.
And David had sense enough to run out of that end.
Yeah.
Can I ask a question? What is it going to take for you this? And David slipped away.
Mm-hmm.
And David slipped away out of Saul's presence and escaped into the night. Everybody look at me, and I'm going to give you a praying moment, even though y'all won't act like you're chosen frozen this morning. How many of y'all glad other times you just slipped away?
Yeah.
Now, I don't mean you got all foot loose and fancy free. I don't mean you escaped without no smell of smoke on you. I'm talking about you just did get back.
Yeah.
Amen.
And when you look back at your situation, you shouldn't have made it out. All the folk that was in the same situation you was in, they dead, they crazy, they got caught some kind of way, but some kind of way, the mercy of God hit you.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And you. Let me help y'all. Don't play with some you just did escape.
Yeah.
I'm going to say it again. I'm almost through. If it almost got you last time, why are you playing in the alligator mouth again?
Amen.
That's right.
He clamped down. That alligator saying, I just missed my meal back.
Yeah.
And if I ever get the opportunity again, that doggone alligator is brushing and flossing his teeth, waiting on you. Because
yeah.
If I ever get the opportunity to chomp, I ain't going to miss it.
Yeah.
Miss it next time.
Yeah, right.
Are y'all hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
Teresa Mama has a story she tells, and I'm through. I'm almost through. That when she preaches, that gripped me the first time I heard it. She said she had a dream in the very house she staying in right now. Said in the dream, she left her door, grandma. Left her door. The devil, she said a man came down the street, and the Lord told her in the dream. That's Satan. He walked by, and he looked at the front door the first time he came down the street. The second time he came down the street, he looked at the front door again. The third time he came down the street, he came to the door and looked in and saw that it was open. She woke up, and the Lord told her, next time he coming in.
Yes.
You have to examine your life today.
Yes.
And see any area of my life that I left a door open to the enemy, I gotta close it.
Amen.
Cause I might not be as fortunate as Karen Harris is. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? Some of us, are y'all hearing, the devil wants you so bad, he coming in the first time.
That's right.
First time.
Amen. And when some of us just slipping away, you ought to understand, I don't want to play it that close no more.
Amen.